Hey guys, it's Tuesday and it's crazy hair day. So I thought we'd start this way. Just take a second and listen. Okay, so bringing it back to me for a second, let me stop presenting this so I can see larger. Here we go. So it's crazy hair day. You can tell my girls picked up my headpiece for today. It's kind of a unicorn headpiece hair extension set. So kind of rocking it. We're looking forward to seeing all of your crazy hairstyles at 10 a.m. this morning. Don't forget, we have live every day at 10 a.m. So hop on there with your crazy hair. Maybe it's ponytails, maybe it's braids, maybe you colored it. But we're looking forward to seeing it. So on with math today. Yesterday, you guys started volume for me and watched a study jams and kind of turned in an exit slip telling me in your own words what volume is and things like that. So what we're going to do today, let me flip my screen again for you. I'll show you the entire plan like I have been each day. Today's kind of a mix again. It'll be harder until we get into this a little further and you guys can do a little more without me. So first thing I wanted you to do after our video today is to watch or go back and do your bell work. Your video with me is going to be right now. I'm going to dig into some stuff and give you some pieces. So two and three we're going to do right now in the video. I'm only going to post this one video for today. And then when we're done, you're going to go ahead and finish just page 266 on your own. Just that one page today. Take a picture and then again submit it to me. Okay. So this is kind of where we're at for today. I do want to say please, 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 please hit the turn in button on your assignments. It just makes it so much easier for us trying to track and grade everything if you could do that. That would help us a lot. And like I've said the last couple of days, your bell work, you should notice that it's significantly easier this week, just from yesterday. And then if you take a peek at today's, it's easier. I'm trying to go back and review some stuff that I feel is a strong foundation and hopefully get some confidence in it for us so that we can keep reviewing some of the things that are harder. So like I keep saying, just keep trying it. If you do your bell work, you get credit for it every day. It doesn't matter if you miss all of them. Now, that's not what I want you to do, but I want you to put forth your best effort and just make sure you're getting that to me. Okay. So, we're going to go ahead and dive into the volume part of our lesson, and we're going to start with some posters today. So, yesterday you kind of learned and discovered through study jams that volume is the amount of space that a solid three-dimensional figure takes up. And I'm going to specify here this three-dimensional piece. That's very, very, very important because the next poster that I want to show you has to do with the dimensions that are involved in volume. So to find the volume, we have to know the length, we have to know the width, and we have to know the height of a figure. So you can see those laid out for you in this poster here. So three dimensions means that volume is going to apply to a 3D shape, okay? We're going to talk a little bit later about those three dimensions doing something else for us. And then we have a formula. Okay, here's our rectangular prism. And we know that it's a 24 by 10 by 12. And the formula that we're going to always use is length times width times height. So mathematically, that's where we're going to get. However, for the rest of this week, we are focusing strongly on just being able to count the cubes that fill a prism. So, with that being said, we are going to open our books to page 266 and 267. Oh, nope, I lied. 264 and 265. You're going to do 266 when our video is over on your own today. So 264 should look like this. Okay, and we're just going to kind of go over this. You might want to underline, or if you have a highlighter, pause my video and go grab a highlighter real quick. What does volume measure? So the volume of a three-dimensional figure is the amount of space contained inside the figure. So what I would probably do here is come through here and underline what volume is. It's the amount of space contained inside the figure. Okay. Volume is measured by the number of cubic units that can be packed into a figure. And cubic units is super important. Okay. Cubic units is the only way that we can measure volume. That's always what our label is going to be. A cube with edge lengths of one unit is called a unit cube. And that is exactly what's over here. This is a unit cube. So it's a 1 by 1 by 1. Okay. And a unit cube then has a 1 cubic unit for its volume. That would be 1 times 1 times 1, which is 1. So the biggie here is up until fifth grade, you've heard about perimeter and you've heard about area. And now we're throwing volume at you. So a big thing that we try to work on in fifth grade is, why is volume different from area? How is it different? Because they are very different. So down below here, area is the number of square units needed to cover a plane. And I want to go ahead and underline that in your book because that's key to this lesson today. Volume is the number of cubic units needed to fill a solid figure. So we're going to underline that section as well. Okay. And then it says circle the figures below that have volume. Remember when we talked about in our posters in our beginning part, volume has to have three dimensions. We're looking for a length, a width, and a height. So down here, we can tell this is my 3D shape. So this would be something that would have volume along with the unit cube. The unit square in area is flat. It's two-dimensional. We measure that in square units, okay? So off to the side, it's talking about a plane figure is a two-dimensional figure. Okay. And a solid figure is a three-dimensional figure. So you can kind of see the difference there. Okay. Now, when might you need to measure volume? So why is this important? I feel like we do this every math lesson. Every time we start something new, we say, why do we need to know this? Why does this even matter? So to try to get this to you at home here, we're going to read this together. Suppose you need to buy a storage box to hold all of your number cubes. All of the cubes are the same size with edges that are one unit long. How would you decide which storage box to buy? So one way to make sure you're buying a big enough box is to use volume. So if you're ever going to buy something in your life and you need to make sure that it holds everything you need it to hold, you need to know volume. So that's why this matters, okay? You know you have 24 number cubes. You can use that number and the volume of each cube to find the volume of the box. So you've got your volume here. And you've got a 1, 2, I like to put dots on it. 1, is it going to let me? 1, 2, 3, 4 by 1, 2 by 1, 2, 3 high. So that's going to equal our 24. So when we're looking at that, our goal for this week is to be able to see a figure like that, to be able to count the cubes, and for you to be able to tell me the volume. That's what we're going for this week, okay? So explaining how 9 square units and 9 cubic units is different, I have a couple different answers. We're talking 9 square units is going to tell me the area, and 9 cubic units is going to tell me that's the volume, okay? So if I type that in there, I know you guys have been asking at home to fill your boxes in. So let me type in here. 9 square units is going to show us the area. 9 cubic units is going to show us the area. Okay, and let me make that bigger if I can. I don't really know how that's looking on your guys' end. There we go. So you can copy that down into your book. So we're talking about square units being area and our cubic units being volume. Okay, so that wraps up these book pages here. I want you to go ahead and look at this exploring idea here. They're giving you a rectangular prism and they're going to ask you how many are in which layer. Okay, kind of just giving us to get a good feel for this. So I want you to just go ahead and do those few simple questions there, snap a picture of it, upload it into our assignment for today, and then click turn in and you'll be done for today. Okay, I hope you guys all have a great day. As always, email me, and don't forget, if you have questions and you viewed this, you can hop into the live chat any day at 10 a.m. We will see you tomorrow.